Hello, and thank you for watching this regional forecast for the Canadian Prairie. I'm Andrew Pritchard, meteorologist with Nutrien Ag Solutions. Well, again, a colder air mass in place. It is going to start to wane as we head through the next 5 to 10 days, but it's going to be a slow road getting there as we try to shake this very cold pattern being dominated by this very strong trough that's anchored across central Canada down into the U.S. We're feeling the effects down here in central Illinois, across the Midwest of the U.S. It is snowing out my window here on April 15th, which is never a thing, but it's a very rare thing to have that down here. So a very cold air mass stretching all the way down into the central U.S. A cold and dry air mass, though. So most areas are going to be remaining on the dry side as we head through the next 7 days, but there will be some opportunities, at least for some lighter snow, heavier as you head off to the north of the prairie, and then back toward the west and the south up against the Rocky Mountains. So you look at the temperatures right now, they are coldest off toward the east, but even as you head all the way over towards the west across southern Alberta, they're very close to freezing and maybe a few degrees below freezing in most places, which again is quite below the norm for this second week of April, going into the third week of April. We'll look at the satellite picture here. Again, watching a disturbance make its way across primarily western portions of the prairie, bringing some light snow right now. We can see that with the radar picture here. Again, some of these snow showers moving from the Grand Prairie area down toward Edmonton, getting some snow in Calgary and Medicine Hat as well this morning. So again, much of that snow off toward the west. And it'll come to an end here over the next 12 hours or so as this disturbance begins to move off to the south, getting into the overnight. And we'll see much of that snow coming to an end. It's certainly coming to an end in most areas here as we head into Thursday morning. We'll be quiet then as we head into Thursday and Friday, and really looking quiet for much of the next 2 days or so. We'll have to look out toward the weekend before we see our next chance for some more organized precipitation, but again, it's going to be very light. We'll look at that here in a moment. Here are your snow totals, though, over the next 48 hours. So this, again, focused very far off to the west, getting into the higher elevations of southern and western Alberta. So here's a look at the upper level pattern as we start off here on this Wednesday morning. Again, a big ridge in Alaska. Here's our big trough anchored across, you know, the Hudson Bay down into the central U.S., bringing this very cold air mass from the Arctic down into the Canadian Prairie. And then again, going far beyond the Canadian Prairie, far enough to bring us some very rare mid-April snow down here in the Midwest of the United States. Now, this pattern is going to continue to hold at least for the next 4 or 5 days. Let me take the drawings off here and watch this transition, though, as this ridge begins to eventually flatten out just a bit. Now, we're already into Monday of next week, so we're talking 4, 5, 6 days out into the future here. We're starting to see this ridge flatten out and slightly move off to the east as we head into, look at this, April 22nd to April 23rd. So there is light at the end of the tunnel, but I'm not promising you that we're going to get there tomorrow or anything like that. As we look at the 500 millibar vorticity plot, again, here's the disturbance that's bringing the snow right now. We're on the tail end of that here across southern Alberta. Let me go ahead and take the drawings off and we'll go through motion here, watching the next wave come in right here as we get into Friday and Saturday. So getting later into the week, we have another shot of some more widespread precipitation. We'll take a look at that here and what that actually looks like in just a moment as this wave begins to kind of wash out, getting into the end of the weekend. We'll then see this ridge again start to flatten out, shifting east just slightly. That's going to take the storm track off to the west. So this is where we get some of the heavier precipitation north of Highway 16, north of the prairie, across northern Saskatchewan and northern Manitoba as we kind of shift this storm track off to the east. Then we see the potential pattern change here as we get into the end of next week, but now we're about 10 days out into the future, and honestly, at this point, the models have not done a great job taking us into that 10 to 14 day time frame when it comes to specifics within the pattern. So let's focus on the slow moderation in the temperatures here and what is really going to be overall a pretty dry next 5 days. So we'll look at the precipitation forecast from the European model. Once again, watching this disturbance making its way out of southern Alberta over the next 12 hours or so as we head into the overnight. We'll then watch a quiet period here Thursday across the prairie, quiet as we head into our Friday. Here's your next disturbance now, the area of low pressure moving through northern Saskatchewan into northern Manitoba during the day on Friday. The precipitation really kind of lingering off to the back side here. So it's as we get into the later part of the day on Friday, we'll start to see some of these light rain and snow showers spreading across the prairie. Again, much of the heavier snow going to be focused across southern and western Alberta, where you've got colder air and some of the upslope action helping out there to enhance the precipitation. So this, again, across the prairie, we're talking about late Friday into Friday night, getting into Saturday. And then potentially with the second wave coming in on the backside here, a secondary of low pressure and a front extending back from that, we could continue to see some of these light snow flurries continuing into Sunday and Sunday night. At this point, then, we head into Monday. This is when we start to shift our storm track a little bit further off to the east. So we'll head through the day on Monday dry, heading through Tuesday. Here's a little wild card here, a little clipper that could maybe bring some snow to southern portions of Manitoba as we get through the day on Tuesday, but really missing much of the prairie. Dry as we head through the day on Wednesday. Maybe as we get into Thursday, talking about some showers, resuming a more active pattern here heading into Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, April 24th into the 25th and 26th. But again, you know what I just mentioned, that's where we're getting out to the 10 to 12 day time frame. So let's bring it back to reality, focus on what is going to be overall a pretty dry next 5 to 7 days, with the exception of maybe a couple of snow and rain showers here as we head through the weekend. So the probability over the next 10 days of 3 inches, that's about 7.5 centimeters of snow or more accumulating. And again, taking this all the way into April 25th. And where do you see that high probability? Well, it's in the higher elevations here up against the mountains in southern and western Alberta. And then it's north of Highway 16 here across northern Saskatchewan into northern Manitoba. We're going to see some opportunities for some snow here across the prairie over the next 10 days, but what you can take from this is that we're talking about light doses of snow and perhaps some light rain too, as we do trend back to a closer to average temperature pattern. So there is snow to be found over the next 10 days, but it's off to the south and west here on the higher elevations of Alberta, and then it is mostly north of Highway 16 across northern Saskatchewan into northern Manitoba. Some opportunities for snow on the light side across the prairie over the next 10 days. A total look at the ensemble forecast here for liquid precipitation in terms of millimeters, again, over the next 10 days. And again, finding the heaviest here over toward the higher elevations up against the mountains, where we're talking about anywhere from 20 to 40 millimeters of precipitation across southern and western Alberta. Elsewhere across the primary prairie region, we're talking about 5 to 10 millimeters of rain, or liquid precipitation. Some of that may be falling in the form of a light dusting of snow, some of that falling in the form of a light cold rain. As you head north of Highway 16 across Saskatchewan and Manitoba, that's where you could get into the 10 millimeter plus range with liquid precipitation. But really, looking at a mostly dry week, and that's to be expected. You know, the Monday forecast, we talked about this, very cold, very dry air mass. It's an Arctic air mass. It's just not one that has a lot of moisture to give. Looking at the temperature anomaly forecast then, as we get started here, April 15th, we're talking about temperatures, especially across the east, southern and southern Saskatchewan, southern Manitoba. This is where temperatures are 5 to 15 degrees below average. So you get into southern Alberta, we're a little bit closer, but still a few degrees below. Let's go ahead and watch what happens here as we head through the end of the week, getting into Thursday, Friday, getting into Saturday. Now you're starting to see things moderate. This is where we get closer to average, so at least we're about where we should be this time of year as we head through the early part of the weekend. But then we do see another push of cooler air dropping us back to 4 or 5 degrees cooler than average over the back half of the weekend. Getting into early next week, this is when we start to see some moderation off towards the west, portions of Alberta and western Saskatchewan perhaps getting warmer than average as we head into Tuesday and Wednesday of next week, still holding on to the cooler side of things as you head off to the east. Taking it on into the end of next week, we kind of keep the same look here. Maybe the west is a couple degrees above average, the east maybe a couple degrees cooler than average, but by and large, keeping it very close to average as we head through the end of the next week. So some moderation here, but still looking for that surge back to maybe some much warmer than average conditions here. Wouldn't that be nice to be able to deal with some spring warmth here? So the message over the next 5 to 7 days across much of the prairie is going to be a continued cooler and mostly dry pattern, with some snow to be found off toward the south and to the west, and then across areas north of the prairie. So Calgary, your average high temperature is right around 10 to 12 degrees this time of year, and we will finally get there as we get into the end of the weekend, into early next week. Similar look here in Edmonton, warming up with the warmer days lingering on the back half of the weekend into early next week. Saskatoon, your average high temperature is right around 10 degrees this time of year, so we'll eventually get there as we get to the end of the weekend into early next week. Regina, and then Winnipeg, here's a look at your next 10 days. Those temperatures finally getting back up to positive territory, or double-digit positive territory, as we get to the end of the weekend into next week.